So this is a really exciting time, I think, in big data analytics, social media analytics. There's been a lot of changes, a lot of firms that have been involved in this area. And I think this is a place where companies that are making big capital expenditures, like energy companies, are starting now to really pick up and use these tools. And there's been a lot of work on the consumer side, lots of people looking at these tools to help with branding exercise or how do I sell more consumer products. But now we're really, I think, moving into a second phase of the evolution of these types of analytics, where people are using the tools now to help with their strategies and long-term planning. And so when we get into energy companies, it's a really exciting field because, of course, they're making billion-dollar bets, huge new investments that are going to be coming up, and they want to use every available tool out there to help them make these decisions. And this is really what we've been focusing a lot on recently. Some of these tools include things like sentiment analytics. So they might be concerned about how does the public feel about this investment I want to make or my operations. We're using things like network tools to help identify who are the most important people in a certain discussion or topic. And the combination of those two things, I think, is really adding some great depth to the type of analysis that companies can use. So energy companies, when they're thinking about large investments, really have to understand the regulatory and the public acceptance of the project that they're working on. Until they can get that right, it's very hard to make the economics of a project work in the long run. And we think that sentiment analysis, that network tools, really provide great depth around these issues. So let me give you one example. In the United States right now, there are a lot of upstream activity, unconventional oil and gas, that are using hydraulic fracturing to open up these new reserves. And the public has a lot of concerns about this technology. Fracking, as it's sometimes referred to. One of the great things about the social media tools is there's a big signal available of how people feel about this and what their response is to certain upstream activities. Now, this could be very localized, what's happening in my backyard, or there's a very big national debate as well. And so sentiment tools allow us to track that over time and see how it's evolving, what's moving the needle, and how are people adjusting to this new technology. And then on the network side, we can identify the people who are most influential. So for instance, in Colorado right now, there's a big debate of whether or not there should be a statewide ban on fracking. We can literally identify the most influential people and groups in that debate and help the upstream companies better understand the environment in which they're operating. And it's these new tools combined with the very best of typical or traditional research methods, when you bring the two together, you really get a powerful combination. So social media analytics is an area that has had a tremendous amount of investment from private industry. We know that companies are spending tens of millions of dollars on trying to integrate this type of analysis and tools into their decision making. And we expect on the energy side, because the bets are so large, because the capital expenditure is so intense, especially in the upstream sector, that they're going to be making very similar types of investments, perhaps even more in this area. So it's a very exciting time to be involved in this field. And I think for energy companies, they really see this as a way to get smarter about their environment and therefore be smarter about their investment cycle. And so some of the examples that you might think about are, say you want to go into a new country of operation, the social media analytics tools can give you a better sense of the situation on the ground, what are the dynamics that you're going to face, and perhaps and being able to respond to unrest on the ground. To give you one example, we know that the social media signal changes dramatically before we have unrest and protest on the street. It's one of the ways that people organize, particularly in developing world. And so if you're an energy company, you have a big asset in a developing country, you can use these tools to really get ahead of the game and understanding the risks that you face, both in real time and also in preparation for an investment. The last example I would share comes more from the economic space. Sentiment analytics at a very large scale or even specialized cohort sentiment indexes that we can build is another way to really learn more about what's happening in the real economy. We know that people's decisions to spend money are often based on how they're feeling. So if you're good at measuring sentiment and understanding how that sentiment spreads throughout a network, you can start to make better and better predictions about economic decisions. So one example might be that sentiment goes down in a certain locality, and we're finding that the next day, almost immediately, we're seeing spending go up on some categories of goods, things that help people feel better. People go out and buy more chocolate, spend more money on the things that they like to do on days that they're not feeling as good. So sentiment measurement is now really getting tied to the real economy, and we're starting to validate it in a way that we never have before. So I think these tools are getting more sophisticated and therefore much more valuable for companies.